Hello and welcome. Welcome to one more discussion. Today we will be discussing about the various features of the two kinds of engines that we have in our ships, that is the main engine and the auxiliary engine. Let us discuss the few differences between the main engine and the auxiliary engine. Well, first point is the main point is that the main engine RPM is very less. It is say ranging from about 80 RPM to maximum of 150 RPM. That is why it is called as a low speed engine. And the generator is a high speed engine. It is a 4-stroke engine and the RPM ranges from 700 to 900 and also about 1000 RPM in some ships according to the make of the generator. So that can be said as a high speed engine or a higher range in the medium speed engine. Main engine is reversible. That means the engine can be has to rotate in the clockwise direction and also in the anti-clockwise direction to drive the propeller in either the ahead or the astern movement of the ship. But the generator is not reversible. It is unidirectional. And one more point is that the main engine is air started. That is the air at the very high pressure, about 24 to 26 bar, it is given to the air main engine cylinders, and as the distributor goes on distributing the airs, as it goes on opening the starting and valves of the cylinders in the either in the ahead direction sequence or in the astern direction sequence, then the pistons are expanding in that way to start the engine in both the directions, in the ahead and the astern direction. But the generator is, it can be air started or nowadays a attached air motor is available which is starting the generator. And one more point is that the main engine is driven with the auxiliaries which are not self-driven. That means the auxiliary parts, auxiliary accessories for the main engine are not driven by the main engine itself. They are driven by the generator power. That means they are external, they are externally driven. Whereas in the generator the parts are not externally driven, but they are driven by itself, the generator itself. Why it is done like that? Because think of a situation when the generator has to be started from the cold condition as in the after the dry dock. Then the time there is no generator running because the power will be received from the shore, and after the dry dock is finished we have to start our generators, and after flooding of the ship we have to start our generators. And what is the then for the auxiliaries like supplying the lube oil and the cooling circulating water, circulating cooling water, fresh water, cooling water, running of these accessories. Then the question comes as to what will drive these accessories for providing the lube oil and the cooling water. Then the generator is, that is why it is so arranged, it is so designed that the lube oil circulating pump and the fresh water cooling pump, it is attached to the generator shaft and they are driven. As soon as the generator starts to rotate, the lube oil and the fresh water are circulated by the generator itself. So the and after the power has been established, the cooling seawater for cooling the lube oil and cooling the fresh water, the pump can be started in addition. So there was time of about say 1 to 2 minutes or 5 minutes is acceptable for the temperatures to remain steady, or it will not rise so much high. And one more point is that in the main engine you will find the turbochargers are either constant pressure or constant pulse type. That means the turbocharger is driven by either a big reserve of exhaust gases from the main engine, that is called the exhaust trunk, which drives the turbocharger with the nearly a constant speed irrespective of the momentary fall in the engine RPM. So the turbocharger can be said to be driven at the constant speed, and that is why the scavenger pressure in the scavenger trunk is also nearly steady at all times. But for the some engines, the turbocharger is so designed that the individual units of the main engine, exhaust trunk, they go and directly hit the turbine wheel of the main engine turbocharger and rotate it. That means they give their individual pulses of these exhaust gases and turn the turbine. That is why it is called a constant pulse type. So because it gives the pulses, the units give their pulses of the exhaust gases to drive the turbocharger. And in this case what happens, even during the low RPM of the main engine, the exhaust gas, the turbine can be rotated, and thus the auxiliary blower for the main engine is not required, as otherwise would be required in a constant pressure type. Because in low RPMs the exhaust gas trunk has not enough of the exhaust gases to build up pressure to drive the turbine, and thus the scavenger pressure cannot be developed with sufficient quantity to meet the demands of the main engine. That is why to meet the demands of the scavenger at the low RPMs, when the turbocharger cannot be driven sufficiently, then the auxiliary blower, which is additionally fitted to the scavenger trunk, it gives the air to the scavenger trunk and to the main engine. This is in case of the constant pressure type. But for a generator, it is never a constant pressure type. If it were a constant pressure type, then what happens? In the low RPM, an additional auxiliary blower will be required. That means, let's say for cold starting, if no generator is running, then while starting of a single generator, then at the low RPMs we will need a auxiliary blower, which is impossible because it is the first ever start generator to start. So that is why in the generator the scavenging is the constant pulse type. That means the individual exhaust gases from the units are going and hitting the turbine blades, and the turbocharger is rotating, and the scavenging box is getting the constant pulses of the scavenger from the turbine. So that is why you never find a auxiliary blower in a generator. And one more difference between the generator and the main engine is that in the main engine, the fuel pumps are of the VNT type. That means, apart from the fuel rack controlling, one rack extra is given, that is called the VNT rack, that controls the injection timing according to the load and according to the manual settings, according to the different qualities of the fuel. But in the generator, there is only one rack, that is the fuel rack. There is no VNT rack. So that is one more point to be noted. And in the main engines, the fuel valves of the recirculating type. That means the even at the engine stop condition, the fuel is going into the fuel valves all the way up to the bottom part of the fuel valve, and it is driving away and recirculating all the fuel inside the fuel valve. But in the generator, it is normally not found, and that is why the fuel is not given during the engine stop condition. And one more point to be noted is that in the main engine, after the exhaust gases are doing work in the exhaust gas turbine, some energy is still left in the form of heat, which can be used to heat up the economizer water. That means during the running of the ship, the boiler need not be fired. which generates the generates the sufficient amount of steam by this heat exchange from this waste heat that would otherwise be lost. That heat is made use of. But in the generators, it is never given to any economizer, because the amount of the exhaust gases is very less compared to that of the main engine. So that is why the generator exhaust gases after the turbine, they are directly going out to the funnel without going to the economizer, because the amount is very less. And one more point is that the main engine can be driven from the bridge also. That means it can be remote controlled from the bridge in the UMS style, or even during the maneuvering it can be controlled from the bridge. But this generator, that cannot be controlled from the bridge. And one more point is that in the case of the generator engine, it has two states. That means either it can be in the idle condition or it can be in the loaded condition. That means it is giving the load. That means, in other words, we can say that the RPM of the generator is almost constant at all times of the running, and it needs to be fixed and maintained at the constant RPM irrespective of the amount of load. But for the main engine, the RPM goes on fluctuating very often, and there is no such hard and fast rule that the RPM should be maintained, otherwise the other parameters or the other things will be affected. There is no such rule, and that much is permissible, because otherwise if there is a very high load and we want to resume the same RPM, then we might have to give a very excessive amount of fuel to burn and maintain that RPM, which might be overloading the engine. So the RPM of the main engine, it goes on varying, and that is acceptable according to the varying loads, like in the rolling pitching conditions, rough weather conditions, or either during the maneuvering, the RPM is variable. But in the generator, the RPM is never variable, it has to be fixed. And in the main engine, the driven is the propeller, and in the generator, the driven one is the alternator, which produces the electric power. And in the main engine, it is producing the mechanical power. That is why the unit of the power of the main engine, it is in horsepower or PHP. But for the generator, the unit is in either kilowatt or the KVA. One more point of difference is that in the main engines, you will see, you will find the thrust pads. That means there are two rods connecting the crank web, the crank pin to the piston. One is the connecting rod and the other one is the piston rod. But in the generator, there is only the connecting rod. There is no piston rod in the generator engine. That is one more point of difference.